Struggling to find relief from arthritis pain? Discover whether or not glucosamine chondroitin sulfate can be the solution you've been searching for. Got a problem with your knee? This is Dr. P, otherwise known as Dr. Mark Petropoli. We're going to be talking about glucosamine and chondroitin sulfate. They are long tongue twister words, and they are actually chemical compounds, naturally occurring chemical compounds in our bodies that make up our cartilage and other parts of our bodies, but especially cartilage. So the question is, can taking these as supplements grow back new cartilage, or can it help my pain that I'm having from arthritis? So there are some pros and cons to taking the glucosamine and the chondroitin sulfate. But first of all, what are they? So glucosamine is a naturally occurring chemical compound that's actually found in shellfish. So it's manufactured by breaking down shellfish into the compound glucosamine. For all of you vegans out there, there is a way of fermenting corn to actually get glucosamine, believe it or not. And I think there's actually a mold where, if that sounds gross, but there's a mold that they can extract glucosamine from as well. So there are vegan options, okay? Chondroitin sulfate, so chondrol means like cartilage. So chondroitin sulfate is another naturally occurring compound in our cartilage, and it's actually found in shark cartilage or other animals' cartilage. And for you vegans out there, there are ways to ferment things naturally to get a vegan form of chondroitin sulfate as well. I get a few questions that are fairly common with regard to the glucosamine and chondroitin sulfate. So one is, you know, is glucosamine or chondroitin sulfate good for arthritis? So there's a couple types of arthritis. There's osteoarthritis and there's rheumatoid arthritis. And there have been studies done that show that it can sometimes help patients' pain. There's no definitive studies that show that it grows back new cartilage. There is maybe some evidence that it may protect the cartilage that people have left. And that was one of the questions that I had. I know there's a study that actually shows that the glucosamine, one form of it, can actually lessen the pain associated with rheumatoid arthritis, but it didn't really show any enhancement. I'm just looking at this paper here of inflammation reduction. So it can help with the pain. It's not earth-shattering, and there's more studies that need to be done. I think if you really look at whether it can help arthritis, it's more, does it actually help lessen the risk of the arthritis getting worse and maybe helps a little bit with pain as opposed to growing new cartilage back? I don't think anybody has proven that yet. Another question comes down to dosing. How much should I take? And I would always say you can ask your pharmacist, you can ask your healthcare provider. I don't want to give exact dosing requirements, but I know that a lot of times the glucosamine comes in 500 milligram capsules. And usually if you look at the bottle, it says take 2 or 3 a day, and it'll tell you on the bottle how to start with and then to taper it down. Because most people start with 3 a day, and then once they have been taking it for a month, because it has to kind of build up in your system, then they might drop it down to 2 a day to save some on the amount of pills that they're taking. Similarly, for the chondroitin sulfate, 800 milligrams to 1200 milligrams a day. Again, everybody's different. Consult your healthcare provider or talk to your pharmacist about the dose. There's no one size fits all. Some people are bigger or smaller than other people, and some people need a bigger dose. Some people need a smaller dose. Also, it depends on your health status. Make sure you let the pharmacist know all the other medications you're on, or let, you know, your healthcare provider know if you're on medications that you're gonna start taking a supplement, and vice versa. You always wanna tell your healthcare providers all the medications you're on, prescription, but also all the supplements you're on, because they can interact. And pharmacists are really good for helping you with that. And then, you know, some of the pros to taking the glucosamine and the chondroitin sulfate are, again, it's gotta build up in your system, but if you're taking it for a month or 2 or 3 and you're noticing some relief from pain, great. If you're not noticing anything, then it might not be worth it. It might not work for you. But what are some of the cons? Well, I was looking up an article, and I have actually taken some glucosamine chondroitin sulfate. I've never had any of these symptoms myself, but these are the actual published symptoms. Some people can get nausea, heartburn, diarrhea, constipation, drowsiness, skin reactions, headache. Especially if you are allergic to shellfish, you don't want to be taking the glucosamine that's made from shellfish. There, again, talk to your pharmacist. Allergic reactions are always a possibility. And really, those are the main pieces of advice I have on it. It's not an earth-shattering thing, but I do think there, I have plenty of patients who take it and they do think it helps some. So it's relatively inexpensive. It's a supplement. You can get it over the counter. Talk to your doctor about it. Talk to your pharmacist and try it for yourself. If they think it's okay, give it a few months. If it's working, great. If it's not, then you haven't really lost anything. So people ask me about taking glucosamine, chondroitin sulfate, and frankly, many other supplements or pills all the time. And I always tell them, you know, there is no one magic pill. We do not have that right now. It's absolutely true. Obviously, everybody wants the quick fix. But I would say that glucosamine, chondroitin sulfate, and other supplements can be an important part of a well-rounded attack in our armamentarium on arthritis, because arthritis is a terrible disease and it usually needs to be attacked on a multi-pronged way, not just with taking things by mouth, pills, medications, but sometimes it requires injections, PRP, bone marrow. Sometimes it requires exercises. It almost always requires a multi-pronged approach. So if people ask me that, I'm going to tell them it's not the only thing you should be doing, but it can be something you can add. And in that regard, it can help some, but it's a small piece of the puzzle. There's a whole bunch of other things that we can do to attack arthritis. I hope that answers that mailbag question. And remember, if you have a problem with your knee, call Dr. P.